that are very rich in mineral resources and also in fisheries. But over the years, the only money we will get from fisheries, now the license we need to, because we're not able to export fish. And if you're not able to export fish, like countries like Senegal, Morocco, and other countries in Africa, we need to, the revenue we will get from that sector, it will be very limited. So what we need to do is that we work with the European Union for them to support me. One, for them we able to export fish to the European country. Then. Two, for them we get a fish harbor. Three, and build a processing center. Then the way we do it, we will create employment for so many people. And that fish harbor, they would build two types. Would build the one what they call the industrial scale, big one. And then we build back the communities, they outside fishing them. To support them, small scale fishermen them. Let them say no go out of business, let them say people produce. Just yesterday, then we be almost the finalizing from people that we in export the salon in the next couple of weeks. Motoka them, frigorific, the camion frigorific. I don't even know how they call up by English. Refrigerated vehicles. So all that need for support the local artisanal fisher people fishing, because until you able to process the fish and export them, you don't go get much. The other area we need support is that we don't get capacity for police in water. So you get all kind of illegal fishing where they take place. The Europeans themselves, they're ready for work with me. We'll provide support so that we will police the water so that people are able to come fish inside 200 miles of the water. So these are just some of the areas then before I come to the individual questions that we are going to answer, where some of its strategic priorities then. Now, the objective, I can't spend some days in Europe. I go to Brussels, I don't come to France. One, that for engage Sierra Leonean community, for tell them thank you, and for explain to them what they do under the new direction. The second, that for can engage French officials then, because one of the overriding objectives, we want to reinforce Sierra Leone French relationship. Voilà. And for the enforced relocate relationship, we get three acts. The first one, the political acts. For the first time, you get the president and vice president as a leader when they want to go to school in France. The president said, we're going to meet the college in France, the French. When you meet up with President Macron and Noël Schott, the French, they will talk. So, that day, in CC, we get this very strong relationship. We want to use that leverage for reinforcing the relationship. So we work and we think seriously for them to open embassy there. And also for letting French people themselves open embassy in Asalo. So that at least the people are learning for the travel go to Conakry. They will get what they need. We work on that. We think about that. And then that's something we want to do. And I want to tell my sister that I thank you that we all live under open learning. Secondly, we also say the French government is very strong in the Union European. Yes. So for strengthen people, then, no doubt, themselves will be a spokes country for we in the Union European. And as you know, Union European is a very big multilateral agency where they support development in Africa. On the economic acts, we get French companies that we need as a loan, where they work, okay? Companies that we need at the port, we need at the airport, Borrowway and Diddy, Sky Handling and Diddy. And you still get big companies that we want to have, big French companies. we want to get you gas and more want to. So we think see, we need to encourage them let them go, because we get big companies them from France, like big European companies. We send a strong message to Europe that Sierra Leone is open for business and that people they can go invest. And we believe say some of them big French companies that they're willing to go, that's what they will get our brother and sister in back class and all suffer them. Because when you go, when you're not salon man, you go to any big company now. The first time we are going to work at the water key, I'm going to go to the office. As I taught French, any man asked me for one coffee. So then you say, well, once we get big companies then, the Sierra Leoneans, the way they talk French, it go easy for knock the door of them big companies then. So we work on that day, because we want to open up the country and we want to let big companies then from Europe go. So we start charity begins at home. We say we serve them, more we care than go first. So we reinforce that economically. The other acts that socio-cultural. Just a couple of days ago, we began an Alliance Francaise. We don't go ask them for go back to Africa. And also, for them, I know Vivendi, the Lord promised they will be a hall, a multi-purpose hall in Africa for 300 places for cinema. They will be there. Africa, we're going to look for the land and the little bit land on we let the French cultural center safely. So we work on that, and a part of some of the objective of this visit. So I want to know, say we strengthen, we want to work towards strengthening relationship with France, because today they get a program what they call Erasmus Plus, which means now African students them can come to Europe for can study. We are going to process, we talk about that, and they send me the list, and the President, His Excellency, the Canada process on the 6th of November, maybe he will likely come to France for a day or two. While the Canada process, one of the team that we will therefore put on the table, now for the Sierra Leoneans and benefit from the Erasmus Plus. So if you already get Alliance Francaise, we begin a brother than the top French, it will make them become more competitive. I tell you, the longer time for waste when they can afford French universities, they just enter straight. So this is some of the objective that this way bring me to Europe for coming business people and government officials. To talk about Sierra Leone, to talk about investment opportunities. What you don't do so far for open up investment? One, would work on ease of business, which means today, in the next couple of weeks, any businessman, any highway dealer in the world, you don't get claim by playing in your salon. You don't need any paperwork. Two, we will try to improve the business climate in the salon. One, we will try to reduce the tax step, for cut down on the tax. And more importantly, for organize water key. Because water key, for reorganize them so that at least when people bring their goods, they don't get too much headache for them. And also they improve what we call the policy and the regulatory framework, what they call it frankly, locata. So that at least we get a framework which will make say people in Google can do business. And then in the next couple of days, establish what we call the Conseil d'investissement, where that the president said decide. And then I for send a strong message to people that we want to invest in Salon. Say at the highest level, we're ready for protect the investment. We're ready for make things very easy for people that can operate in our country. The issue of deportation. You know, in the last couple of months, from when we take over, we don't inside transition. During that transition period, we have been still get ambassadors to meet. So a lot of things go on, a lot of things that go on. As I talk now, even the Salon Ambassador to process, you know, kind, because the process came down. So many things they go on. So the people that waiting at your respective embassies them, do not get the sufficient power for grapple with some of the issues them. So what do you define? You find out, say, This social media today, even somebody can deny teaching, it creates trouble for people. Yeah. So the kind of information they want on the social media.
Tell them, fast
pass what they have.
Tell them.
But our Lord alone say, under the new direction, we objective now for take care of the Sierra Leoneans the way they outside, not for facilitate for embarrass them.
God bless you, sir.
That number is the objective. The objective, why we want strengthen relationship now, now for the citizens there. And we, Alefia, one of the first tasks we will give the ambassador of Sierra Leone to Belgium, and for they establish a focal point for France. We will get somebody in that embassy, they will not get no work for work for France. Till we able to go to the other step. Yes. So then we will make sure so that, because I believe, after England, and obviously any other country will challenge people population for salon business. So if salon people will forget attention, any side of Europe, after England, before being in France.
God bless you, sir.
So we will work towards that. We will establish that focal point. We will come, we will find way out, we will do it. Because more importantly, the associations, they already there, the wonderful work we do for try to promote and support people in a salon, you know, for be a dick for them. That we responsibly government for help their association and they, where they ship things them, where they send things them, where they go support people in a salon for make their things easy for them. So we go put a focal point at the embassy in a process. When they go to Canada, you can meet with their association and their people and they for make sure say they facilitate everything that they do in a salon. And we will go right now, we try for reorganize the state house. We don't say we get a diaspora office. We reorganize them, try for make them more effective. When once we get that day plus the local content office, we will make sure say they will link up to every association the way they around the world, with the Sierra Leone associations, the way they go for go help Sierra Leone. You don't find you don't need a France, you take all your time, you spend money, you spend your time, you they ship things there for people and poor people in a salon. When you go salon back, you get headache for pulling back now. That is unacceptable. Allowed and also in the meantime, why would you try to put that into place? The office is open because my office will not help a lot of association there for clear waiting in the same, let them not pay, and then we ensure so we transport them for them. So, the office is open in the interim. Why would you try to put that there so that at least that they will give people the confidence for continue for help their citizens there? You don't go reach their country, the headache when they pass, so you come out. Way busy, way richly. So we work on that. You understand? In the office you opened yesterday, I don't meet some of our brothers there. Where they help, we brought a full father with them, and where they help them, handicap them as I know. I don't share the number with them. I say, we go free to make a contact me. Because any assistant with their association they are, and their individuals they are, need us alone, and responsibility for provision. So on that occasion, I want to tell all the association that thank you very much. For the time on the spend, this is such a very patriotic act, you know, and I pray that they will give a long life and will continue that kind of humanity that we do. Then, on the accident, well, accident will take place in Juba, not to lack of enforcement of rules, not a mechanical problem. You know, combine mechanical plus small human error. So, I believe, say, recently been done conscious of that. In the last couple of years, not only this year, since last year, there's been increase. So, we try for be more vigilant. We try for enforce rules then. And we try for improve the control technique. You know, control technique of vehicles. So we need in the process for discuss with the company and the outfit. We will come, we will establish locally, we will help with that control technique. Because the control technique will make all the vehicles that we work on the road, them be the worth, you know, the road worthy, so that at least they will secure. And more importantly, we'll try in the next couple of months, we'll increase recruitment in the police. So we'll be deploying more police people than for police the road. Already we don't start Nasalo to the call preventive policing. If you ask the people away in Africa, they will tell you, say now 24 hour net, that the major junction then you see police people in. So insecurity in Africa now reduce considerably. But with the intent for expand, with the expand on that is seriously. You get you don't touch the ghost teachers. You know, ghost teachers, not to today start Nasalo. Don't start for long. We just done last week, we just don't complete, I think say we don't complete the verification exercise for all civil servants. Everybody today we know for government Nasalo, we get in picture, we get in fingerprint, we get in name. So they're not going to pay you 2 term. Nobody need to collect 2 salary. We get fingerprint, we get picture, we get your name. We just don't complete that exercise. So then they automatically don't eliminate ghost teachers. But under the free education, not the ghost teachers more we worry about. We worry about ghost children. The ghost children now, you don't say the free education. We they give money to the school in relationship to the number of people the school get. So the ghost children, now when the headmaster go up 100, increase up to 150 because of one money. So that they will call ghost children. And then they will also send a very strong message saying, under the new direction, anybody when you try for sabotage the free education, we will deal with you according to the law. This is not a law and other governments. I believe say, that message they don't pass. Headmaster they take us seriously because we don't begin arrest some people and we don't begin deal with them. In terms of investment, I don't talk about what will be investment. The airport, I don't talk about them. The accident, education.
Let the light back. The light.
The mineral sector. The mineral sector. The mineral sector. Most of the companies them, where they only operate over the years, most majority, they be suffer a lot of losses and shocks. Like the brother we talk about Shandong. Shandong virtually ago. They get difficulties for resuscitate the industry, but they don't get, we recently they don't get renewed capital. The Marampa mines, we get companies that we don't show interest. Because what really happened as I know before is that you get past 60 companies there, but the only company they are, the portfolio company there. The people in the go, they go take license, don't they take the license and they work out around the world, forget investors. So most of them license and they don't cancel now. They cancel more.
Wow.
So they will not say only the individual or small. Anybody who give license will investigate you, will make sure so you get resources, you are a serious company before you license. So that phase they will do, and when they talk to a very serious company then, for Marampa and the gold mining companies, we in the next couple of months, Marampa will likely open with very serious company and very serious capital. Not for the individual. So we did try for restructure that whole mining sector, eh? But more importantly, now for less alone benefit out of the mining sector, not to just for them, we just the companies that we can do, we know we will promote the growth we want. So that we get for the light. Electricity, what's that we need to do? When we take up will take over at the time where Freetown alone will need like 60 megawatts for Light Freetown. And we get Bumbuna will produce 40 megawatts. During the dry season, it is reduced to less than 10. So you get a company with them called Agrego, where the former government been signed for getting. Because now our electricity they operate in Freetown is that companies that they generate electricity, they sell them to government, then government sell them to the people. So the former government they may buy light 36 cents per kilowatt hour, and then they sell them to the people 18 cents. So already losses daily. When we come, every month we will pay nearly 30 billion lion for support Freetown for get light. And we decide say we no go do am, we no go continue because we get free education for people. So we no continue the contract. So we sign a new contract, which is Turkish boat. From 36 cents, we buy 16 cents. So today, government don't spend that kind of money. We receive over $10 million per year from the previous government for just the light in Freetown. So today, we don't reduce the cost from 36 cents to buy 16 cents. Even the last contract we just signed at 15 cents. So within this 16 cents, even within even before whether is if they sell them to the people, the company will responsible for electricity distribution, they're not able to collect 40% of that money back. So what will they do? They try to restructure the sector. Because electricity not about hospital. Not about hospital, water, education. If you spend money, then you hope for make profit. But electricity, if you don't make profit safe, then you don't put money there. Let the electricity be able to take care of itself. So we work seriously on that day. And then more importantly, we invest for big transmission line. One of the challenges for the light in Asano is that you don't get the pole for send light from one town to another. You get like Potlock also, but they produce 2 megawatts. The whole of Potlock will use less than 1 megawatt. The other 1 megawatt is waste. You don't even get pole for Karangola, Cambia. So now we invest on transmission lines, distribution lines, so that when they generate electricity, if the tunnel will use all, the Kononi Street, then get 2 megawatts. The whole of Kononi will use 1 megawatt. Because electricity, na salon, na for light hose, and light phone. So you will find out, say, not to ya. You go Kono, maybe you go work at the wall, Kono, an office, you go see 2 microwaves. So the electricity we need and for light the hospital them and light the house and charge phone. So not too big. That make the whole of Kononi Street neighbor use 1 megawatt. Maybe if you check all your Subwa alone number will use past 100 megawatt. And another day the wall salon will use 100 megawatt. Because also we use now to call utility energy, not a productive energy, not no. Industry.
No.
So as a result, we never work on the light, but the focus will be on renewable energy, solar electricity. So right now we talk to a lot of companies that we want to salon, and we want to invest in that domain. We go to the call energy renewable. But only we focus on and then we expand. I try to go point by point. The inflation where we just take over the dollar price will go up. We take some measures for stabilizer. But the reason being where you get a new government will come. The old one that we want go. The rush, the panic. And businessman confidence, and at the same time, a lot of offices then will be in transitional mode. So you expect, say, we will also try for meet If a businessman, they forget foreign currency, so the loan will go up. But His Excellency the President makes some measures to try for stabilizer. But the more important thing, like I say, until we are able to develop a domestic production, even if we know the export, at least the small dollar we'll get, no, not take them for the buy from outside. It will help us stabilize the currency. And if we export, if we increase domestic production, we expand the industrial base, we believe, say, we will be able to put the loan under control. And more importantly, we don't put measures then back for control, because we will get intelligence of dollar money we will pull outside. We are most down there in the social media. We catch somebody with almost $1 million, but a young business standing. So all the measures they don't put in place, we will control the dollar. But the more importantly, that we'll get more dollar in the market, so that we businessman the way they do business, particularly when they buy fuel and rice, they're going to get sufficient currency for do that day. But if you open up the country, you get more industries than inside the company, more businesses than come, it will reinforce the currency. So that tells them we will deal with inflation. We will deal with inflation through that. I don't know whether I still look the note. If I don't respond to most of the issues then. But more importantly, I want to summarize or send two messages. First, now a message of optimism. Say, this is a government that is committed, determined to move the country forward. With the head of state and a vice president decomplexing totally. We're the only thing we see that will let the country go before. And we work day and night for push that day. The second message is that government alone by itself not able to turn around country. You need the people then, you need the citizens then for help for turn around the country. Where will they travel, will they go around? Get a lot of people that will raise issues about free education, about this or two. But when you optimistic, say things are going to turn around, it create hope. And then we believe, say, every Sierra Leonean, particularly the Sierra Leonean that we did at the diaspora, we're relatively independent as the one that we did. Because Sierra Leoneans then are the diaspora, they even take phone and call people in Asalon and tell them that for football. Because most of them are independent. So, every Sierra Leonean outside in the diaspora to look at this new government, this new direction, say, the effort we will make, the effort we will put, the determination we will show, you know, in the area of social service delivery, the commitment we get for turn the country around need the support, the blessing, and the effort of every single one. So we call on that. Make una be optimistic. Make una get hope. Say this brand of leadership can now ready for move Salon forward. And it not going to be a very easy patrol. It will be a very long patrol. We are going to Potloko. I tell the people of Potloko, say, we get a bus, when the bus don't take off, the bus they go, the only way where the people that will benefit before Polene enter that bus, they therefore in a four-road. Four-road will call up until in a junction.
Junction.
So if you're inside the bus, the bus will pass, you're not going to go inside the bus. So they ask the Sierra Leoneans and say, we don't show commitment and determination, we want to make a kind of junction. so that we the boss need to make ourselves do. So that I message the 1 cent. And one Lord and also say, we're not going to forget to now. Particularly me, not going to forget to now. Now I'm here, I spent 10 years there. I go to school there, I work in Abolo University. Up to last year, every year I retire, this is my place. So if I therefore start, we visit inside, outside of Sierra Leone, I will not decide saying that I will start up.
Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup.
I'm glad if Ataya woke up and see so many of the people who spend good time together now. My brothers, them day, KBJ, them, my sister Safia, the Sian from Yanda, who are in Abodo, my sister, them, they're all the good time we spend. I want to tell you that thank you for all that make time for come. I want reassure and say, we will work in the interest of Sierra Leone and we are determined to move Sierra Leone forward. Thank you very much.
Thank you. God bless you, sir.